My name is Lois Stackelrow, and I am honored and humbled to be your spiritual leader and ready to work to prepare our chaplains to be able to show our strength to their veterans. As we begin a new year, it is my responsibility to show all chaplains throughout the state of Florida that they need to be ready to show the strength we have and how compassionate we are to be honored to help our neighborhoods and our veterans. As you know, chaplains are known as spiritual ambassadors for our organization and should always be prepared by carrying a small book of prayers in case you get asked to do a prayer at the last minute. Are you ready to show our strength along the state for our veterans? As spiritual ambassadors, we need to be aware of the diversity of all faiths and cultures. Be courteous to everyone, and please try not to offend anyone. Provide emotional support and spiritual support to the members and their families by just giving them a smile, a hug, or just a simple touch of the hand. By doing these items, we show dignity and respect to everyone. All prayers must be non-denominational, and that means not restricted to or associated with any specific religious denomination. Be prepared at a moment's notice to say a prayer or to assist in a ceremony. This can happen while attending a meeting, a community function, at a special dinner, or at a memorial service, or sometimes even just being needed by someone to say a kind word to. Do not hesitate to assist if you see someone in distress. If they don't want you to comfort them, they will let you know. We, as chaplains, try to send out birthday cards, get well cards, sympathy cards, thinking of you and congratulations cards during the year. It means a lot to a member who can't get out and be with us. For our deceased members, we drape the charters. Invite your family members to attend the service that is held at the unit meeting to show how you honor their loved one. They would appreciate that. Hold memorial services when asked by a family member, or if the unit is asked, be prepared to conduct the service. Don't forget to send your deceased member forms to both your district and department chaplains. If they do not receive the form, then the member cannot be included in the memorial services at the end of the year. Forms can be found on the department website under Forms and Resources by going to www.alafl.org, then click on the link Forms and Resources and look for unit forms, then look for deceased member form. Please make sure that all unit chaplains have my address to send these forms to. However, I will accept the names via email, which is chaplain@alafl.org. That way you save money and I get them a lot faster to honor them each month. Please do not wait to the end of the year to send all the names in. We like to receive them on a monthly basis in order to honor that member in a timely manner. The cutoff for names to be included in this year's memorial service at convention will happen on June 3rd, 2021. So please do not hold the names until the end of the year. Send them as you receive them, even if they pass 2 months prior and you just received the information. As long as they are a member, we will still honor that. This cutoff is due to copying of the names in time to be placed in the programs for the memorial service held at convention in July. Any questions, please see me after the meeting. Well, you're going to have to write to me. Sorry. Please let us know if you participate in patriotic ceremonies, such as the Four Chaplains, flag disposal ceremonies, Wreaths Across America, and any others that you may get invited to attend. We'd love to hear about them. Please report them on the year-end reports so your unit gets counted and it helps the department at the same time. Please do not send checks to me. All checks need to go directly to department headquarters. They know what to do with those checks. Visit members who are ill when you can. And don't forget, you can go to other locations besides hospitals. As a member, maybe in a nursing home, a rehab center, or even at their individual homes, they may be convalescing. Include your junior members in your visitations, in your ceremonies. Junior members love to learn, and that's the way they learn how to do what chaplains do. We need to spread the wealth out to everyone. Prayer books being submitted for competition must reach the department chaplain 30 days prior to convention, which is June the 3rd, 2021. Prayer books are a collection of prayers that means something to all members of the unit and or district. All members should be asked to contribute to the prayer book for either unit, junior, district, and or department. And then it will be a huge success. Another way to add prayers is as a department president visits districts, please ask the chaplain from that unit or district or event to send that prayer to the district chaplain to include in her prayer book. With that being said, I would like to ask all the district chaplains to send me prayers that may be read during Department President Ann's visitations, whether it be at a luncheon, a dinner, or just a small get-together. Or if you have a favorite prayer that you would like to have in Ann's book, please send it to me. On the books, white binders are preferred but are not required. All prayers need to be centered, both vertically and horizontally, on the pages. Include the author's name, make sure it's centered. Only one prayer or devotional thought per page. Even if it is a one-liner, it must be by itself on the page with the author and centered. Please use spell check. Even have a second set of eyes or a third set of eyes look at your prayers for spelling errors. And please remember, if you do use a cross, then you must use the Star of David. Please see all of the rules in the unit guide. Remember, strict adherence to the rules must be followed. Resources. Chaplain's Manual. This can be downloaded from National Headquarters website. There's a beautiful prayer book from a national chaplain. I have copies of that. I use them. Chaplain's Prayer Book can be purchased through emblem sales, or use a white binder to create your own. Look on the internet for non-denominational prayers. Create your own prayers. I do a lot of creations, as you know. Use the American Legion Auxiliary Magazine for inspirational thoughts or ideas. Again, your program action plan gives you the outline of everything that I discussed here today. Awards. The winner of the prayer book will receive a May Nally plaque. All entries will receive a certificate. As long as the rules are followed that are in the unit guide, we should see our chaplains strengthening our veterans. Let's see what we can do this year. I know it's hard with this pandemic, but I'm sure a lot of chaplains are out there doing what they're supposed to be doing, and I, for one, am grateful to them all. Please keep up the good work. Your deadline dates, unit year-end reports, are due to your district chairman April 1st, 2021. District year-end reports are due to the department chaplain April 15th, 2021. There is no mid-year for chaplains. I want to strictly enforce that. There is no mid-year report for chaplains. It is strictly year-end reports. I thank you and hope to see you all soon after this pandemic is over. Take care of yourselves and stay safe. God bless you all. I just want to let you know that our award this year, there was only one prayer book submitted. It was from a district chaplain, and that goes to Linda Hall of Lehigh Acres 323. Congratulations, Linda. Your award will be mailed to you. It's just running late. So just hang in there, and congratulations.